How's everyone doing? Did you arrive safely in Italy? I had my little hiccups on the way here. How about yourself? Yeah. I was reminded of my over-reliance on technology on my way here. So, but then I remembered that this was just to use the way how it used to be like 20 years ago anyway. So didn't make me feel as stupid. Who of you was here last year? All right, that's a lot of you. So I had the pleasure to give the keynote of last year's conference, but I'm pretty glad that I don't have to do a full talk today, since today my honor is to act as your host, as your MC. I'm Johannes. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I'm Johannes. I live in Berlin. I do a few different things. My main thing is running a product company called Over Engineering Studio. I was accused of over engineering things, so I now just own it and made it the theme of it. I'm also part time and an advisor to Effectful and trying to contribute to Effect. And as a few other things, I'm also the host of the Cause and Effect podcast, which we started last year. And the past, you might know me from being the founder of Prisma. So to get a few things out of the way, a few notes on housekeeping. First of all, this event would have not been possible without some really, really awesome sponsors. So a big thank you to Nato, from France, who's in the medical field, clinical trial marketplace, who are a huge supporter of Effect for a super, super long time, contributing, already sponsored last year's conference. So huge thank you to Inato. And also from France, we have the awesome folks from Everick here, who are a consultancy based in Paris. They're also the hosts of the Effect meetup in Paris. I think we have quite a few folks from Everick here, so also a huge thank you to them for sponsoring. And obviously, we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Effectful as well, who is the company behind Effect. So huge thank you, particularly to the organizing team, to Mirela, for making all of this happen. So thank you. So your primary attention should be on the talks, obviously. But if you want to connect to the outside, we have Wi-Fi here. It works okay-ish. If you're not connected, you can use a QR code, or you can... All right, now the cursor's out of the way. you can connect to this one. Also, restrooms. If you've been here yesterday at the workshops, you might already know, but restrooms are just downstairs. And we might not need it for an emergency, but there is an emergency exit over there. But you can also use it for non-emergency reasons, just to enjoy the view on the beautiful ocean. So it's just behind you, and I highly encourage you to, like, if you take a break, go outside. Super, super nice. I mean, that's what this venue is all about. And I hope we're all having a great time, and we should let the rest of the world know as well. So feel free to take pictures, share your thoughts on whatever platform you feel like it. But yeah, with all of that out of the way, I just want to get back into the theme of Effect and what for me Effect is all about. And I mentioned that last year's keynote. For me, Effect is all about like taming complexity. We're like the quality bar is rising and rising for the products we're trying to build, and that is a lot of work. There's so much complexity, and I'm trying to like reduce the accidental complexity as much as possible and keep it to the existential complexity. And I feel this is where we just need a great foundation. That is what Effect gives us. And I think this is what brings a lot of us here. So I just wanted to start with that and take a quick stroll through last year, since last year we got a lot of stuff done. The team got a lot of stuff done. So starting with effect itself, I was actually doing a little, I was doing a little AI-based scraping thing of like how many releases we had. And I think it was like over 3,000 releases in total because there are so many different packages. But more meaningfully, we had 13 really, I don't want to call them major releases, but they almost deserved a term, like really big releases of effect itself, which now encapsulates schema, etc. And so huge thank you to the core team working on that. That's amazing progress. So, but besides just the code, we need to learn about the code, and we've also made amazing progress. Particularly, Julio has made incredible progress on the documentation. So I tried to get a grasp and like try to roughly quantify how much progress we've made in the documentation. If you've like been around with effect for a long time, the, this was always like the Achilles heel. That's like supposedly great technology, but how the heck should I learn about it? And we've made so much progress in that regard. And just we've been already in a much better spot like a year ago from compared to the year before. But just over the last year, just for the reference docs itself, when you go to effect.website/docs, the docs there in content-wise has like more than doubled compared over the last year. But beyond that, we now also have like really, really great JS doc coverage for most methods and effects. So right in your editor, you get like helpful explanations, helpful examples, etc. The we worked on the docs infrastructure, so just to make the entire entire site experience faster. We very recently improved the search, and we also, given it's not just us anymore learning effect, but also those like big AI matrices. So we also made the docs AI ready. So I just want to give a huge shout out to Julio for working relentlessly on making the docs better for all of us. Another huge quality of life improvement. Oh yeah, this is our new YouTuber. Maxwell has worked for quite a bit on the effect playground, which came together as like a small idea and then really like compounded in meaning. And I think we're now, I'm using it on a daily basis when I'm experimenting with something with effect. And the goal was to lower the barrier to entry, to just play around with effect. And I'm really excited how it turned out. It's also where we embedded the effect dev tools right away, and we intend to make it better over time. So really excited about this one. great work, Maxwell, for shipping this last year. And also over the last year, we kicked off the Cause and Effect podcast. We already had two amazing guests here. We have Attila, who was the first guest. We have Michael from MarkPrompt, who was the second guest. And also, so thank you so much for the guests. And also thank you so much for Davide for like doing all the amazing work on the video content. And also last year, we also already got a bit of recognition from the broader web ecosystem, and we got an award for that, which luckily we had someone from the community take the award. So thank you so much for you for going there to take the award. And yeah, really excited that we got a bit of recognition from the outside. Yeah, but also just overall traction has more than 10x last year by NPM numbers. That might be AI agent, might be other things, but I think overall people are coming around to effect. We've also more than 4x the GitHub stars from last year, so let's see where we are next year. And there's now almost 20,000 GitHub projects that are using Effect in one way or another. And I couldn't figure out the trajectory of this, but I remember the number being a lot smaller last year. But more meaningfully, there's also now more and more companies and enterprises using Effect in production. And I think that's really a meaningful change compared to last year, where companies were just getting their hands dirty with Effect, and now over the last year have really rolled it out in production. So I'm really, really excited about that, that like Effect helps small companies, small startups, small projects, but also large companies. And I'm super, super excited about that. And I think that's not a coincidence, not a surprise, because TypeScript is winning. Like, there's so many exciting advancements in regards to TypeScript. I think it's such a great trade-off. Just when was it, like 1 or 2 weeks ago, when Microsoft blew us all away with making TypeScript whatever X faster? I can't wait for to actually get my hands on that for my own projects. Michael has already done some tests, and I think it mostly compiled just without any problems and ran how much faster? 7x faster in the Effect repository. So, and I'm sure the folks at Microsoft have a lot more improvements there in store as well. So super excited about that. And we can now also just run TypeScript with Node, with Bun. Super excited about that. And if you're looking at the conference schedule, you might actually think you're at an AI conference today, since we have like, we have almost, I think we have 5 talks about AI. But that's also for a good reason, because I think there's sort of this virtuous cycle where Effect makes it a lot easier to build AI products. I think this is when you build AI products, this is where you're kind of in the eye of the storm of complexity, where everything can go wrong. You're dealing with streams, you're dealing with like API endpoints that are timing out, that you need to retry, et cetera. All of those things Effect shines at. But we've made it even easier through the Effect AI package. There's also some interesting work on making it easier to build MCP servers through Effect. But also the virtuous cycle goes the other way around. AI now makes it easier to build code with Effect. Very recently, we've added the LLMs.txt file. But Cursor is already pretty good working with Effect as well. We have already, for quite a bit, built our own AI-driven apps with the Effect bot, you might know from Discord. And also, again, we're looking into MCP to make everything better, maybe even in our Effect dev tools. And so I just want to also encourage you, if you're using AI to build Effect apps, please let us know where we could do something better. Like the LMS.txt file was mostly due to like some requests and encouragement from the community. And we're looking for feedback to help those AI systems to help you get the most out of it when working on Effect. So with that, I want to already hand it over to our next speakers. We're starting with Maxwell Brown, who will open the conference with his keynote about Effect AI. But we'll also later hear from Tim Smart about Effect Cluster. A little bit later, we're hearing from Mattia about Effect DevTools. And so those are just like from the Effect core team. And I won't reveal yet what Michael will talk about. But yeah, without further ado, please give it up for Maxwell Brown.